Our country has been chock full of guns for centuries, and there was no talk of massacres of school children until around the year 2000. That's when it really started. They started talking about it. This is not a gun problem. This is a mental health problem. This is a social problem. This is a cultural problem. This is a spiritual problem. Convene an independent outside panel to investigate whether transgender hormone treatments and ideology increase the risk of extreme depression, aggression, and even violence. I think most of us already know the answer, don't we? Furthermore, we have to look at whether common psychiatric drugs, as well as genetically engineered cannabis and other narcotics, are causing psychotic breaks. A lot of problems. We're having problems that we've never seen before, and people sort of think they understand why. But let's be very clear, the issue is not too many guns. The issue is too many thugs, hoodlums, and savage criminals on our street. That's really what the issue is.
Oh, good. Oh, I thought he was gonna get through that whole thing without racism. Anyway, so I don't know what genetically engineered substance he must be on to believe any of that, which he doesn't.
John, it's the dabs, it's the shatter. Very potent, very strong. I did a dab and I swear I drank 150 Diet Cokes. Mm-hmm. I also call that a Wednesday.
Is a dab, isn't that futuristic ice cream you can get in the mall?
No, those are Dippin' Dots.
Oh,
and that would be really yummy. Yeah. And you would trip for days and forget how to breathe.
Anyway, okay, so you had him basically listing all of the things that they like to hear as excuses. Trump, of course, doesn't care about any of this. Trump is not going to the range. Trump doesn't read like guns and ammo. Trump doesn't care about literally any of this. Like, if you're a conservative and you're watching this, you know that that's true. This guy's not obsessing over the new Remington or whatever. He doesn't give a damn about any of this. He thinks you're all gun-toting weirdos. So maybe him and I have something in common too. Anyway, but it's a spiritual problem. Okay, this is a guy who's definitely an atheist. There's no way that he would elevate any being above himself in his ideology. And then of course he turns to the trans issue. So we're gonna convene a panel to scapegoat trans people. And we already know, by the way, that it does it. It definitely does it. Because there was, after all, that one shooting, you know, out of the hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of mass shootings, there was that one thing. There will be no panels to investigate what it is about being cisgendered that makes so many people massacre people around them. But just for this one, and you know, Francesca, the final thing before I throw to you, I absolutely love when they'll be like, there's a mental health crisis. So presumably America has more mental health issues than other countries, which of course we know isn't true. Mental health issues are a human thing. They're found in all cultures. But let's assume that it was true. At the same time, they demonize all of the treatments for it. Like,
yeah,
they do not believe that literally anyone in any case should ever go to therapy or anything like that, let alone any pharmaceutical aid to treating mental health problems. So the problem is the scapegoat and the solutions are the problem. I don't get it. What do you think?
No, that's a perfect way of explaining it. They have no solutions for mental illness. And because, again, it is the ideology of no empathy. They don't want to take action when they say there's a mental health crisis or people are disturbed or traumatized. No, they don't believe in therapy. They don't believe in low cost prescription drugs, right? They don't believe in affordable healthcare. They don't believe in expanding Medicare and Medicaid to include mental health services and expand them to all people. They don't believe in lowering the age when it comes to when you can receive Medicare. They don't believe in any of the things that would help people with any kind of mental health crisis. They just believe in pushing the little Nazi button that says, oh, throw you down the chute, goodbye. You know what I'm saying? This is like, oh, and you're done. Survival of the meest. Like, that's all it is.
Okay.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.